All right. So now I'm going to be playing this game, which you may remember. It's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Part 2, the arcade version. As opposed to Part 1, which, if you've seen, like, any video game nerd or anything like that, you know is a complete pile of shit compared to this game. Because this game is fucking awesome. Now, I don't know shit about Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. All I know is that they're turtles, and they fight people, and that's about as much as I know. And apparently a cheese grater or a shredder is involved, and there's something about splinters. I don't know. So I'm playing this game because I used to play this game a lot. When I was a kid, it's fucking awesome. And now that I play it now, it seems kind of cheap and repetitive because, I mean, these levels are really just like, they're really just short hallways, but you gotta stop like every three steps and fight like 10 guys and just deal with it. But it's still pretty cool. And this is, by the way, I'm gonna put this in the title, this is going to be a no continues run. Because you play this game, you start out with 3 lives, and then if you lose all your lives, you have to start over. Well, you don't have to start over, you get a continue. I don't remember how many continues you get. I think maybe it's 3. So you get a continue, and you get to restart the level that you were on, and you get your lives back, and blah, blah. But I'm gonna be playing this game, and I'm gonna die. I'm gonna say right there, I'm gonna die. I'm not gonna use any continues. So that's gonna be my claim to fame with this game. So as you can see, let's get to the basics. I picked Donatello because he's the best turtle. We all know he's the best turtle. If you don't think he's the best turtle, then apparently you have mental issues, because he's clearly the best turtle. There's no other alternatives that are remotely as good as this turtle. One, because purple's awesome. Two, he has big stick. Three, he's smart. He's got everything. But from a gameplay perspective, he has apparently the longest reach with his attack, but the slowest attack speed. But the attack speed doesn't really fucking matter, especially if you kill things in one shot. So, I mean, you're not even gonna, like, I'm gonna be using the attack every now and then. Mostly, if I jump behind a guy, I had to smack him in the back and then jump over his head, do it again. Or I'm gonna be using the insta-kill attack that you see me doing, the little jump, the little half leap smack in the face attack. Besides that, you're not really going to be using the regular attack very much. You're going to be focusing more on the jump kick, because the jump kick does the same amount of damage and as the regular attack, and it's a good way to traverse and dodge attacks. So, like, you see someone's going to take, oh, fuck you. See someone's going to attack you, you just jump out of the way. And then maybe you can land a hit on them. Half the enemies in this game, especially all the bosses, it's the most efficient way to deal with them. You just fucking kind of chain smack them, just smack, smack, smack with the jump kicks. You're going to see a lot of that, because bosses get radically more difficult as the game progresses. Partly, their attacks and their reaction time gets way tighter, so that you can't just continuously spam jump kick on them without taking hits, unless you're really, really fast with your reflexes. But they also get way more health as it goes along. If you remember the penultimate boss in this game, which is I don't know his name. He's the fucking little alien brain looking guy that's inside of the giant robot. As I told you, I don't know shit about Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I know very little. I know this guy is Rocksteady because I read about it before I started recording this commentary. That's pretty much my... It's like, Rocksteady, you can't do the normal thing that I'm going to do against all the other bosses, because he has a gun and he likes to shoot it up in your face. So if you just keep doing the back and forth smacking I'm going to do with most of the other bosses, then he'll just shoot you out of the sky. So you got to be careful. But it doesn't matter. I mean, look how fast he's dying. You can see the faster he flashes, the closer he is to death, just like real life. Because I know when I've been in a fight and I'm about to die, that I start flashing. So, come on, after that Shredder creep, you douchebags. So now we're fighting on the street. I mean, first we're gonna save April from a burning building. Maybe I got it all wrong. Maybe Shredder isn't the villain. Maybe he's a good guy, because technically he did save April from the burning building. I mean, he also stole him from us, and he's gonna do horrible other things. Probably rape her, or maybe that fucking evil scientist who's half fly is gonna rape her. I mean, there he is taunting me on a TV, which apparently has crazy giant subtitles. Love to get a TV like that. And he's just constantly on the TV. It doesn't change. Maybe it's a recording. And it's just paused. The guy is on the VCR back there, because this was the 80s. So, nobody had DVDs or anything. Don't want to fall in that hole, because you'd think, okay, I'm a turtle. I'm going to spend a lot of time in the sewer, like they do it in the shows or something. I mean, they live in the sewers, don't they? But you fall in a sewer, you take damage. Aww. So these guys have dynamite. So you got... Well, fuck you. Punch me in the fucking face. That's the one thing I hate. You try to do attacks and they just punch you out of the sky. Like fucking dicks. So as you've probably surmised so far, all these regular enemies are going to die from two regular attacks. Or from one of those super attacks. Which, if you haven't played the game much, don't know how to do a super attack. You can't just hit A and B together. You have to kind of... It's weird. You gotta hit A slightly before you hit B. Kind of roll it over. Once you get the timing down, you're golden. So when I eat a slice of pizza, I refill all my life. Because that's totally how turtles work. You know? I mean, I know they're vegetarians, but not these turtles. When you mutate them, they eat pizza, and all their vitality comes back. All her wounds from getting hit by blades and dynamite and shit just completely goes away. They're totally fine. So I'm smacking these guys, walking down the street. So these yellow guys, they have boomerangs. And that's bad, because boomerangs suck. So if you can kill them, basically I like to do a thing where you may have been noticing that I will get on a plane and focus and force them to come down to my level. But the AI is more intelligent than that. They don't like to just let you fight them one-on-one because they know that you'll fucking kill them. So they'll usually put the guys on separate sides of the room and have them both come at you at the same time. So that if you hit one, you get hit by the other. Which is exactly what's happening right now, and it's pissing me off. So look at this shit. You hit one guy, and you go to hit the other guy, and he fucking hits you, you just can't escape. But it's cool, it's challenging. But it's not as challenging as, like, Streets of Rage or anything like that. You didn't really have attacks that were as overpowered as, the fucking super attack or even the jump attack. This guy's a little bit more complicated. Spend more time jumping away from him than jumping on him, because you don't want to get, first of all, you don't want to get punched in the face, and second of all, you don't want to get hit by the laser beams, and third of all, you don't want to get hit by a body check, so you're going to charge after you. So jump over his head. I don't know what his name is. What is his name? Bebop? I think I read that somewhere. So I think he's a little bit tougher than Rocksteady was. But he has way more moves, so you have to be more careful. And I hate that attack. A little laser attack? It's annoying as shit. And guess what? There's gonna be a regular enemy popping up later on in the game where there's gonna be tons of them at the same time, all the time, and that's their normal attack. It's fucking infuriating. And I hate it. It pisses me off so bad. So I'm gonna jump in those sewers, I'm not gonna take any damage. Ooh. Level 3. Now I'm in the sewers. Which, this is apparently, this is the the most well-lit sewers in all of the world. Everything is bright and cheery. The water is blue and clear. It's just a fantastic sewer. I mean, you can fucking live down here. This is fantastic. Look at it. It's not even dirty. If this is really a sewer, there'd be shit everywhere and fucking rats. Which there are some rats, but they're robotic rats, so they're not there intent. They're not there, you know, because they're rats. They're there because someone. Okay, get out of the fucking water. That's a good pro tip. If you haven't played this, in the sewer level, don't go in the water because fucking missiles come out and hit you. And they don't care if you're just in the water. They'll hit you if you're on the little side there too. So these little rats, they like latch on your arm and they do damage and it sucks. So you hit them twice, rats are coming out the hole, and I think there's five of them, and you move on. And they're gonna be another hole right there. Break that one, kill them, move on. I don't think I'm gonna make it on this level, but, you know, I said it's gonna be a one continued game. And you're thinking, well, this game has like 10 or 12 different levels, and they're gonna get way harder. And plus, those boss fights towards the end, if you play this game, this game gets fucking ridiculous. Especially the final boss. The final boss is insane. So how are you gonna do it? We just want to continue. I mean, surely you're gonna die a couple of times. Well, here's the thing. I don't know if other games did this, I don't remember. But in this game, if you get 200 points, you can see the point total going up there. Every time I kill an enemy, I get 1 point. And when I get 200 points, I get an extra life. So that's how I'm going to survive. So, more of the rants. See, you fucking missed it, and now I have to take the damage. Bite me in the arm. Stupid. Get out of the water, you dipshit. So there's the fucking poles of death. I don't know what's... I don't know what the fuck those are supposed to be. They're just there coming out from the edge of the universe. Apparently God has just spawned them to piss me off. Yeah, it's kind of weird, because some of the enemies, you know, you know based on their color, because every enemy has a different color, and based on the color, you know what attack they have. But, some of them, you know, explicitly use their attack, their special attack, and some of them don't. Like, I'm fighting these blue guys, and you know the blue guys, they have the knives, they throw them all over the place. But some of these guys are just walking around like dipshits. They're not using them. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe some of the blue ones don't have the knives. Maybe I'm just mistaken, because some of these palette swaps are really, really hard to discern. You can't even tell the difference. But there is a difference, so... I don't know. This guy... no clue what his name is. Some douchebag engineer... trying to be Dr. Wily, but failing horribly. He is completely useless. He's a completely worthless boss. I think he takes more damage than the other bosses I've fought so far. But he has no attacks. He comes out, and he, maybe he takes less damage. All he can do is drop those fucking rats. Which, by the way, you could just sit there and, exploit that. You just keep killing the rats and getting points, because you'll get points for every rat you kill. You keep doing that until you're tired, and you can, you know, maybe get a couple extra lives. Ooh, that's so intense. They actually capitalized turtle soup. They didn't capitalize other words. It's like a, it's a proper noun, turtle soup. Maybe there's a country called, what, really? I hate when you get hit by shit that you can't avoid. And get hit in the face with a fucking block of ice. Which, why are there giant blocks of ice falling from the sky? That doesn't make sense. I mean, the boss of this level is going to be throwing giant ice blocks at me. I just hit 200, so I got an extra life. And I have 3 lives. Or actually 4 lives, because, you know, I still have the existing life. Totally clipping through that thing, but who gives a shit? As long as you're not on the bottom half, then you don't get hit. It took me forever to figure out an effective strategy to fight these guys. And I'm still not really great at it, but there is no health items in this level. So if you want to beat this level without taking, having to expend the life, which I don't, because I need to save all my lives for the end, you gotta do it just right. They're really annoying. They shoot rockets that they're homing. There's the snowball guys. But they're not throwing any snowballs because I'm fucking kicking their ass. There's one. Kicking their ass before they can throw them. But you see how I wait and let them come to me, but then they always come in pairs, one behind me and one in front of me? I mean, it's kind of simple, but at least it's hard to exploit. It's challenging. I like it. It's good. There's more of the generic ones, which are actually, like, they're the easiest ones because they don't have any special attacks. But they fight the most aggressively. I mean, sure, they can't throw anything at you, but look at them. They're constantly jumping around and punching in sync, and it's ridiculous. Especially if you gotta fight 100 of them every fucking level. It's ridiculous. Here's another one of them ice things. Ice trucks. For no reason. As long as you don't hit that spiky part at the end, you're fine. I like these snowball guys, they're pretty cool. But unfortunately, we're never gonna see them again. We're gonna see them for this level. There's no more ice themed levels, so they're never gonna appear again. I killed all of the ice putty, all of the ice feet. I wanted to call them putties, because they remind like the Power Rangers. Remind me of the Power Ranger guys, for some reason. They're the foot. All the ice foot, or feet, I guess. Foot is, foot can be a plural noun, I guess, in this case, because it's a proper noun. All of the ice feet are... Damn it! All of the ice foot are dead. They will never come back. They're extinct. Which, apparently, there's so many, like, little meta stories going on at the same time, and I got hit in the face with another ice block, because this is bullshit. There's, like, all these meta stories to this game, besides, like, the obvious thing where, the obvious opening story is that, hey, there's a burning building, and April was in there and had to save her. And then Shredder stole her, so now I gotta go find where they're keeping her and steal her back. So I don't know who the fuck this guy is. A giant bulldog with a leather vest throwing ice blocks, which, another thing is, okay, it would be one thing if all of the ice blocks that were falling on my head were being thrown by this guy, right? But when he's throwing ones, like, he's catching them out of the sky, they're falling from oblivion into his arm so he can throw them. So apparently he's not in control. So I think he takes way more damage than the other ones, but look how fucking easy he is. He don't give a shit. All you gotta do is avoid those ice blocks and hit him right as he's about to grab them so he drops it. And you're done. No problem. Or you can hit them and then wait for them to throw one, run to the other side, and then hit them again. So you can do that. You can do whatever you want. So here's one of the meta stories, right? So I destroyed that little weather control device because apparently they brought it out and brought unseasonable winter to New York. So I had to save New York from the ice.